Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Babatunde. In this tutorial, you will learn how to build a reusable reactive form that you can use anywhere in your Angular application. Why would you want to build a reusable form? Well, reusable simply means that it can be used again, and that way you don't have to build from scratch or litter your Angular application with one same form. Building a reusable form simply follows a programming principle called DRY. It simply means do not repeat yourself. This aims at reducing repetition of software patterns. So then, how do you build a reusable form in Angular? Well, Angular has a technique for sharing data between child and parent components, that is, from parent to child and vice versa. To implement this pattern, you need to use the at input and output decorators. The at input and output decorator give a child component a way to communicate with its parent component. The at input lets the parent component update data in the child component, while the output decorator lets the child send data to a parent component. So, how do we go about this? First off, we need to import the reactive forms module in our app.module.ts. So inside the imports right here, I'm going to type reactive forms module, like so. We need to build a component. We need to add a component. So to do that, click on Angular generator component. I'm going to call it login, like so. So this login is going to be our child component. Essentially, what we want to do is we want to be able to call this login component anywhere in our Angular application. Let's say in our application we have two login components. Maybe you need to log into two different dashboards. It depends. But the idea is we want to have one login form that we can call anywhere else instead of building another login component. All right, so let's go to our login component and add a couple of tags. So let's add our form tag here, and in our form tag we want to add two divs. So the first div we want to call a label here. Okay, our label, and we'll call this username. Close that. We also need to add an input here, type of text, and we need to add a placeholder. We call this username. Alright, so I'm just going to copy this and paste it here. So this is going to be our password. So of type password, call this password. Alright, so we need a button. Okay, so we have our form here. I'm just going to add some space down here. Okay, we have our form tag, we have two divs, right? We have two divs, and we need a button. So, add a button, and we call this submit. Okay, like so. Alright, so let's go to .ts and add a little bit of logic. So like I said, to share data between parent and child component, you need two decorators, the at input decorator and the at output decorator. So I'm just going to import at input, alright, like so. And then we call this title of type string. And we output decorator. Okay, and the way we're going to do this is we're going to give it a variable login event emitter. Alright, can do of type any is equals to new event emitter, like so. Okay, so let's create our form here. I'll do a simple digital create form. Okay, and I'll call the method here create form. Again, we do. So we need to create another variable here for our form object. I'll call this login of type form group. Okay. Login form. So we call this just login form here. And we create an instance of the form group, like so. Okay. We have our username object, username property, and we create a new form control instance. Okay, we're going to set it to empty first. We're going to add a validator for it. So validators dot required for the username. We need to add another form control for the password, and we do a new form control instance. We set it to empty at first, and then we call our validator validators dot required. Okay, like so. That's good. All right, so let's go over to our login.html and add our form control name here. Form control name, exactly like the way we've written it in the .ts file. We call this username. We add for password as well, form control name. We call this one password. We need a way to emit this value on our parent component. Alright, so I'm going to create a function here that's going to send the data from the child to the parent. Okay, so I'm going to call this onSave method, and the way we do this is by calling this dot login, which is this one, this variable here. Okay, this dot login dot emit the value. So what are we emitting? We're emitting the value of our form object. Which form object? This login form object. You want to emit the value. So we do this dot login form dot value, like so. All right. So we need one more thing. We have our form control name. We have our form. We have form control name for the username and also for the password. So we need to call the function here using our click event. We do onSave method. That is the name of the method here, onSave. Okay, save this. All right, so let's call this in our parent component, which is the app.component. So I'm going to clear this out. And first off, I need to, okay, so the name of the selector is called app login, app-login, which is what we're going to call here. So The way we do this is by app.login, and we close this app.login. Okay, so we have an error. Since template pass error, app login is not a non-component. That is because we have not declared it in our app.module. So I'm going to come over here in our declarations, and I'm going to call login component. Okay, so our login component is now shown on the parent component. Nice. So let's go over to a login component, and what I want to do here is I want to add an history tag. I'll call this so we already have an input here called title, so I'm going to call it here. This title, add it here, and then in my parent component, to do this I'm going to use the property binding, and title equals to title in our parent, and we want to update the value of title from our parent component. So here create a variable called title of type string. Now call this login form. All right, so back in our login component, we need to call our login form in our login template. All right, so we do form group, and we do equals to what do we call it again? So login form, and I'm going to paste it right here. Login form. Okay, so we have a login form, and we have our username and our password. So let's test this out. So before that, we need to emit the value to our parent component. Okay, so right now we don't have a way to call this login event here, which we created here. Okay, so this one's safe, right? Come here and add a method called onSubmit, and takes event. So we want to console.log this event. Okay. Then here, to output that unsafe method, we need to use an event binding. We call this login. Right, and we are going to tie it to our onSubmit method. Like so. And we are taking the event that is being passed, the value that is being passed. Alright, so let's test this out. And we have username. So we can see the value is being passed to our parent component, which is actually nice, but we need a way to disable this form if the values here are not correct, or if the values have not been entered. So to do that, I'll go to my child component login, and I'll do property binding disabled, and if this form is not valid, so what's the name of the form? Login form dot valid. Cool. So now our button is disabled, until the values in this form controls are correct. Nice. So let's try another one. Sam. And pass. Submit. And there you have it, folks. All right, guys. That is the end of the tutorial. If you like this tutorial, make sure you subscribe to this channel for more content like this. And also like this video. Catch you on the next one.